थैंक यू सो मच।
क्या कुछ कहना चाहते हैं आज के खास मौके पर?
बस इतना ही कह सकता हूँ कि मैं बहुत ही गर्व महसूस करता हूँ और बहुत ही शुक्रगुजार हूँ अपर्णा जी का कि इतनी मेहनत, इतने शिद्दत के बाद इतने सालों में इन्होंने एक मिनट भी हार नहीं मानी और आज हम सबकी मेहनत को एक किस्म से एक पड़ाव पे जो लाके रखा है, आई थिंक इट्स ग्रेट एंड आई एम वेरी 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 थैंकफुल टू हर। कि होता क्या है कि हम लगभग साल डेढ़ साल लग जाता है एक फिल्म बनाने में, और फिर वो फिल्म अगर गॉड फॉरबिड किसी रीज़न से नहीं आती है तो फिर लोग वो फिल्म भूल जाते हैं। जिस किस्म की मेहनत हमने की, हमने जिस किस्म से दिलो जान से वो फिल्म बनाई, तो लोग भूल जाते हैं। मगर वो मेहनत बड़े पर्दे पर आनी ही चाहिए। अगर फिल्म शुरू हुई है, कंप्लीट होके रिलीज़ होनी ही चाहिए, और इस किस्म से इतने अच्छे पैमाने पर रिलीज़ कर रही हैं, बहुत कम लोग इस तरीके से करते हैं। मेरी पहली ही फिल्म जॉनी गद्दार करीबन डेढ़ दो साल अटकी थी, और उस समय भी मैं जानता हूँ कि बहुत लोगों ने हाथ ऊपर कर लिए थे ये कह के कि एक अटकी हुई फिल्म नहीं आती, ये फिल्म कभी रिलीज़ नहीं होगी। मगर मैं जानता हूँ कि किस किस्म से हम लोगों ने जॉनी गद्दार पर भी मेहनत की थी और एक अटकी हुई फिल्म आई, और आज अगर मैं हूँ आप लोगों के सामने तो उस एक फिल्म की बदौलत हूँ। तो मैं जानता हूँ कि क्या गुजरती है, क्योंकि एक फिल्म से कितने लोग जुड़े होते हैं, और उन सब की मेहनत आज आपके सामने आ रही है। बस उसी से खुश हूँ कि जी।
नील, फिल्म नेम इज दशहरा।
जी,
जस्ट लास्ट वीक दशहरा।
या
पर लगता है कि इट्स गोइंग टू रियली अफेक्ट है डेफिनेटली वो एक दशहरा के मौके पर जो फिल्म सामने
की, जब फिल्म, हां जी, जब फिल्म राइटर जो है हमारे फिल्म के, ये फिल्म का नाम तो बहुत सालों से है, तो हम ये मौके का इंतज़ार नहीं कर रहे थे कि दशहरा आएगी तो दशहरे पे रिलीज़ होगी। इट जस्ट हैपन टू बी वेरी कोइंसिडेंटल। जब आप फिल्म देखें तो कहानी जो है वो एक्चुअली कहानी दशहरे के इर्द गिर्द प्लेस की गई है, और क्योंकि एक पॉलिटिकल सटायर है, एक पॉलिटिकल थ्रिलर है, रुद्र प्रताप सिंह का जो किरदार मैं निभा रहा हूँ इस फिल्म में, बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग कैरेक्टर है क्योंकि दो पहलू हैं। अब वो जब एक स्टैंड ले लेता है और आगे बढ़ता है कि ये कैसे इन चीज़ों को कनाश कर देगा एक किस्म से, तो इट्स वेरी सिम्बॉलिक इन नेचर ऑल्सो फॉर द फिल्म टू हैव अ टाइटल दशहरा, बिकॉज एज ऑल इंडियंस एंड हिंदूज एंड पीपल हु ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड वुड अंडरस्टैंड रिलीजन वुड नो व्हाट दशहरा इज़ व्हेन राम वेंट आउट देयर एंड डिस्ट्रॉयड रावण एंड कट ऑफ ऑल हिज हेड्स। So it's about those 10 elements that were put to rest by Lord Ram. Not that I'm depicting Lord Ram, or there's nothing religious, in the film, but it's very symbolic in nature that a man who's an encounter specialist on one hand has to be so cold-blooded, but on the other hand he's a husband. He's also a man who's got a family. He's also got those emotions in him. So to create that balance between two emotions and then go out there and take a stand for women and for their empowerment, I think that was very important. When we started the film, all these debatable topics that we are discussing now in the last 1 week, unfortunate events that have happened, those weren't there. There was this one topic that we were making on the film on, after which so many incidences have come. That's why I'm very happy that the film's seen the light of day, because it's a topic that needs to be discussed and put to rest. Yeah.
Film posters say quite powerful. Agree, your performance, your look is very powerful. What have you said? Because I lag raha hai ki kuch film mein, you know, it should be really something trying to convey a good message. Yeah, it should be.
It's something that. Was put on my shoulders with great responsibility. I'm very thankful to Aparna ji that the writer and the director of the film, that they considered me worthy of portraying this character. First of all, it's along with being a mass entertaining film, it's also a very topical film. It's also got a topic very delicate. There's a storyline behind it and there are some incidences in the film which are based on some true facts. When you see the film, you will know about what we are talking about. So when you are going out there and portraying a cop on screen in a thriller, in a political satire, you're shouldering a very mature character. When I had done the role, it was about a couple of years back, so I was much younger. I wasn't married at that point. I didn't have a daughter at that time. I wasn't mature enough to understand what it actually meant to be a husband, or what it meant to be a father, or what it meant to go out there and fight for. But as an actor, I tried to depict that character, and I did a lot of R&D. Luckily, the way the film was written, I didn't need to do too much homework on it. But so, answering your question, the look looks powerful because of its certain maturity of its characterization, which I have never portrayed on screen. This is the first time on screen that I'm playing a cop. And my belief is that in India, if you're playing a cop, you're somehow playing a superhero on screen. Because I can speak, ever since I was a child, for me, a cop on screen means a superhero. From Ram Lakhan days to Singham, to Dabang, to all of them, whenever a hero has gone and portrayed a cop on screen, I don't know why, but I get this rush, you know. I feel empowered, I feel powerful, and I just get goosebumps every time. Keeping a few of our current superstars in mind who've portrayed that character on screen, like Salman Bhai, Ajay Sir, we've made sure that we live up to a certain amount of action which they have followed in their films with Dabang and Singham. But as far as characterization, we've also portrayed it very differently. So I hope you'll like it. I think it's not just this one topic. In general, I think the film, and we all always support women empowerment. It's very unfortunate that we have to talk about women empowerment. It should be all the time. It should not just be one topic of discussion for one phase, then we forget about it. In fact, I was just giving an interview earlier and I said that there shouldn't be a thing like this existing, because we as human beings have evolved so much. Women have taken up such great stands in such great professions. We have a woman powerful more than a man in every profession possible. Every person should stand up for themselves, shouldn't be shy about anything. So whether it's your current movement of Me Too or whether it's women empowerment, it should be vice versa, even for men, even if they are subjected to something that they are not happy about. You're after all just a human being, you know. So I think that sensibility and that emotion kind of starts from home, that upbringing. So that should be inculcated from much earlier.
Society में जो इवेंट्स होते हैं